History is a clock people use to tell the time of day. The history of a people should tell them who they are as a people, where they come from, what they have accomplished, and what they must accomplish. Welcome to the Pan-African Museum of Heritage and Culture. Since the beginning of humanity in Africa, from where our ancestors emerged, humans have sought answers about origins. Who are we? Where do we come from? How did the world begin? Their answers to these questions form the core of their communal identities. As human societies sought to ground contemporary experiences in the past and explain the familiar through stories, they come to define their places in the world through narratives. These narratives speak of creation, beliefs, and cosmogonies, which tell how the cosmos was created from a primal state. These narratives also speak of origin, which explain how extended families, social institutions, cultures, and humanity itself came into being. We may argue then that Africa is not only where our human ancestors developed, but also the front from which all human cultural traditions flowed. The idea of origin is prevalent in all human societies. However, only Africa can claim the origin of the species we now call human. Thus, the importance of its ideas about creation of both the world and humanity. And now, the story of creation from the Azande narrative.
Mbori created the universe long before the memory of any living being. Mbori is almighty, invisible, and seen in all creations, such as humans, the rivers, the mountains, the forests, and the savannas. Mbori created the universe of humans and animals at the same time and put the entire creation into a round canoe, which was shut tightly with one small entrance sealed with wax. A message was sent to Mbori's children, the sun, the moon, the night, the cold, the day, and the stars, telling them to come quickly to prevent the death of Mbori. The sun alone treated the messenger appropriately, and so the secret of the concealed entrance to the canoe containing the creation was revealed only to the sun. This is the creation narrative of the Azande people.
From this narrative of creation, humans were born in Africa.
The first principle of Pan-Africanism is the recognition of Africa as the base of human existence. The African continent has been at the origin of all developments of human civilization. According to Sheikh Anta Diop, quote, six specimens called human, if we could characterize them as such, the term being improper for some of them, these six specimens are all born in Africa. The three latter, the Australopithecus robustus, Australopithecus gracile, and the Homo habilis, developed and migrated to populate the other continents. At this point in prehistorical archaeological research, all have been found in the continent of Africa. Homo erectus migrated out of Africa probably about 1,700,000 years ago, exiting through the Suez Isthmus and the Strait of Gibraltar, and went on to enter Europe. These first humans were born under the Kenya latitude in East Africa, which includes Ethiopia, Kenya, Tanzania, and South Africa. The Homo sapiens sapiens, that is the human like all of us, the latest form of humanity who migrated from Africa about 40,000 years ago. They went on to populate Europe. This is the process of the apparition and formation of humanity and also its migration from Africa toward the other continents. If humanity remained only in Africa, it would not have been differentiated into races. The African continent presents a climatology that does not justify racial differentiation. Thus, race is a geographical notion created by Europeans to create categories of human beings. This humanity, which was born in Africa in the Homo sapiens sapiens species, was necessarily black. Humans born under the Kenya latitude in prehistoric time, in order to survive, must necessarily be pigmented to be protected from the ultraviolet flux under that latitude. This screen of melanin is therefore functional. It is a shield which protects the organism from the ultraviolet rays, allowing it therefore to survive. This is why humanity born in Africa was necessarily black. In migrating to Europe, in the prehistoric time, it faced diametrically opposed climate conditions to progressively whiten to become leucoderm, a person with a white skin. The monogenetic origin of humans in Africa, which seemed unbelievable some time ago, has been confirmed by prehistoric archaeology. Africa is the birthplace of humanity, and the peopling of the world occurred from Africa. Thus, Africa is first to enter the historical period, inventing writing as early as the end of the fourth millennium, end quote. Africans went on to create civilizations, empires, and states. Nagada, Kush, Kemet, Napata and Mero, Ghana, Mali, Zimbabwe, Congo and Swahili. They federated their peoples, built a common vision, mutualized their forces under just, enlightened, and wise leadership.
Indeed, history can repeat itself.
Children of the grooving to how I fall.